In this reaction, we have to find out A, B, and C. So this type of roadmap questions are very, very important. Isopropyl bromide on heating with alcoholic KOH gives alkene. Dehydrobromination takes place. HBr is removed. After the formation of alkene, again hydrogen bromide added, but in the presence of peroxide. During the addition of hydrogen bromide in the presence of peroxide, it follows anti-Markovnikov's addition, opposite to Markovnikov's rule. So after the formation of again propyl bromide, it is reacted with sodium ethoxide. B2C is Williamson's ether synthesis. Isopropyl bromide on heating with alcoholic KOH elimination takes place, beta elimination. H plus is eliminated from beta carbon, Br minus is eliminated from alpha carbon. Totally dehydrobromination takes place, forming propene. After the formation of propene, again this is subjected to the addition of hydrogen bromide, but in the presence of alkyl peroxide. In the presence of alkyl peroxide, it follows anti-Markovnikov's rule. So according to opposite to Markovnikov's rule, H goes to carbon with less number of hydrogens. Bromine goes to doubly bonded carbon with more number of hydrogens. Then we can get CH3, CH2, CH2Br. So simply isopropyl bromide is converted into N propyl bromide. After the formation of N propyl bromide, it is reacted with methoxide, sodium methoxide. So here methoxide acts as attacking nucleophile. The carbon which is holding bromine is electrophilic carbon because of the polarity of the bond between C and Br. So O minus acts as nucleophile, attacks at electrophilic carbon via transition state. Br minus is replaced by OCH3. We can get CH3, CH2, CH2, OCH3. This is nothing but methyl N propyl ether, otherwise numbering 1, 2, 3. 1-methoxypropane. This is 1-methoxypropane. So answer is C. They are asking C. So C is nothing but 1-methoxypropane. Correct answer is B.